वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व LeetCode प्रॉब्लम 187 रिपीटेड डीएनए सीक्वेंसेस। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट लुकिंग द डिटेल्स ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम एंड इट्स इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, आई जस्ट वांट टू मेंशन दैट आई ऑफन क्रिएट LeetCode कोडिंग सॉल्यूशन वीडियोस एज वेल एज वीडियोस टू हेल्प पीपल इन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर जावा J2 इंटरव्यूज। So if you are preparing for Java J2 interviews or preparing for coding for the interviews, then this channel is for you. I have a lot of playlist, good playlist like explained with examples as well as discussion for frequently asked interview questions and how to answer them. So please look at my playlist and subscribe to the channel. Your subscription to the channel will be really helpful. So please do so. So let's look into the details of the problem. The DNA sequence is composed of a series of nucleotides abbreviated with AC, G and T. For example, they have given us this is a DNA sequence. So when studying DNA, it is useful to identify repeated sequences within the DNA. So given a string S that represents DNA sequence, return all the 10 letter long sequences, substrings that occur more than once in DNA molecule. You may return the answer in any order. Okay, so they have given us a long string of DNA and we have to identify repetitions of the DNA sequence, right? DNA sequence is of 10 letter long basically, right? So basically this is one of the famous problem. This problem is asked by Google in their interviews. So please make sure you understand this problem and practice this problem. So let's look into the details of this first example they have given us, so we can I can explain you how to solve this problem. So this is the input string of the DNA sequence that is given to us, and we have to find out the repeated DNA sequences. So what we are going to do is we are going to cut these DNA sequences in length 10 length strings, right? So we can whenever we are cutting the 10 length string, we will put that string into hash set 1, right? So for example, let's just first see which first 10 letter string, right? So as you can see, this is 5 and this C. So this is the 10 letter string until this point, right? So this one we will cut it and we will put it into our hash set 1, right? We will create two hash sets, 1 and 2, and we will keep putting the 10 length string. So as you can see, this is the first string that I put, then the second one will have like this A, and from this A until this A, right? So this one, you can see this one is the second one, A, and then C, and A, right? So this is the second string of DNA sequence. So similarly, we will keep like put all the 10 length strings, right, into our hash set 1. So as you can see, when we reach, like we have reached until this point, so now when we will like, so as you can see, this is the all the 10 length DNAs that I have shown you here, starting from this point until this point, right? All the, these are all 23 strings of DNA 10 characters, right? So when we come at this point, so now let's say, so this is the DNA sequence that we find. So this is again a 10 letter sequence, so A, C. So this sequence, whenever, like when we are trying to put this sequence into our hash set 1, now it is going to bounce back because there is already a sequence present there, right? This first one. So it will bounce back because you cannot put a duplicate value in the hash set 1. So what we will do is we will capture that and we will put it into hash set 2, because that is one of the repeated DNA sequences that we have found. So as you can see, this is the one that I put it into hash set 2, because this one bounced back when we are trying to put it in hash set 1, right? So similarly, this highlighted one, right? Let me highlight it for you here. So C, and A, right? So this is the one that we already found here. So now when we go at this point, right? This one, C, and A. So this one again, it's getting repeated. So when we are trying to put the second time, it will bounce back with the false, right? Because hash set one, when you are trying to put something in a set, when it's already present, it will give you false. So we will know that this is repeated, right? So again, we will capture that and we will put it into our hash set two. So that way we will know, these are the repeated DNA sequences. So in this string, we only have two of them. So we'll just capture that in the hash set two. And at the end, we will just, for example, I'll just show you now the solution implementation in Java. So this is the pretty much the idea that I already explained you here. So here we will create a list of strings called as result. It is just a simply array list that we are going to return, right? Because that's what we are expected to return from the function. First thing, we will want to check if the length of the string that is given to us, right? If it is less than equal to 10, then we do not have any DNA sequence, right? Repeated DNA sequence, because DNA sequence length is 10 basically. So we'll just return the list, result list in that case. Then we have created two hash sets, 1 and 2, and this is the length of the string n, and we are looping from 0 to n minus 10, right? 0 to n minus 10 we are looping, and then we are getting the possible DNA sequence as a substring, right? That means I to I plus 10 basically, which is 0 in the beginning and 0 to 10, then 1 to 11, then 2 to 12, like that it will give possible DNA sequence. And we will try to this system out. I just put to show you actually, so I can just comment that out. So we will try to add that possible DNA sequence into our first hash set, right? So whenever it bounces back, what we will do is we will just add that possible DNA sequence in the second hash set called as 2, right? Because it is bounce back means it is repeating basically. And at the end, we will just say result.addAll2 means it will take all the elements from set 2 and it will add into our list, and we are going to return that list. So that is the approach that we are going to take. So this is the first sequence that is given to us. So let's first run this first one and make sure it's working fine. So as you can see, we are getting the correct result here as well as, so we will just use the both examples that they have given us here, and both should work, both test cases should pass. So both test cases are passing, so we will just submit our solution here. So our solution is 91% faster and 83% on the faster in the memory side, right? Which is pretty good. So on the time complexity side, what we can see is we are iterating through, let's say, 0 to n minus 10, right? So basically this one will be order of n basically, right? We are going through almost like all the string, because n minus 10 means still we will consider it as an order of n. And then the time complexity, I'll just write here, time complexity for this solution is going to be order of n, right? So that is time complexity. And the space complexity, you can see that we have created a list of strings as well as we have created two sets, right? So maximum, you can say like it will hold maximum how much, like 10 repeated sequence, one repeated sequence will get all the times repeated. So it may be going to be order of n, right? Maximum. So that will be the space complexity. So for the solution, so that is the way you can solve repeated DNA sequences using the help of two hash sets. So we will just go through the string and we will cut the string, like always get the substrings of 10 characters, and we will put them in the hash set 1. Whenever it gets bounced back, because already existing, we will put it in hash set 2 because it is getting repeated, right? And at the end, we will just convert this hash set 2 into the list and return the list. So that is the way. This problem is an important problem. Ask at Google. So check it out and try to practice this problem. As I already mentioned, I often create LeetCode solutions. So check it out, my LeetCode playlist. It has over 80 problems solved and explained with examples. and also check out the Java interview playlist. It has a materials for if you are preparing for Java J2 interviews, you will know what are frequently asked questions and how to answer them, as well as different concepts in Java and you know, like design patterns, those kind of things. So please check it out, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. The subscription to the channel, I will really appreciate. If you like the videos, please like and subscribe. That is really, I would appreciate it. Thanks for watching the video.